Breeding and selection must be made under organic conditions. And why is this so important?
I think there is a simple answer. Seeds are the basis for a diverse and hopefully healthy food.
Plants must be able to cope with the dynamics of a nitrogen availability in the soil, and they must cope with with weeds and pests on their own.
Viele Nutzergemeinschaften, viele Nutzer von diesem Saatgut profitieren und von der Züchtung, von den Ergebnissen der Züchtung profitieren. Das sind nicht nur die Landwirte und die Gärtner, sondern es sind auch alle, die nachher kommen, die die Produkte verarbeiten.
Seeds and varieties belong to the cultural good, so they are, so to speak, a patrimony of mankind.
Wir stehen jetzt wieder vor einer Agrarreform und vor so einer Reform wird ja immer ein bisschen reflektiert, man analysiert, wie ist die Situation. Und wenn ich auf die Situation innerhalb der Landwirtschaft und des gesamten Ernährungssektors schaue, dann stelle ich eine große Monopolisierung fest, innerhalb der Ernährung, aber innerhalb auch des Landwirtschaftssystems.
I have far too little organic plant breeders and too little organic seed companies.
We have to enable an adaptation to climate change, and with the present varieties developed, I cannot see that this adaptation potential is increasing in plant breeding. Farmers and society as a whole are getting increasingly dependent on a few companies, and this process has progressed already very far. And for breeders, free germ plasma is getting short. So there is an imbalance of seed exchange.
Open sources Lizenzen sind zum Beispiel eine Antwort auf diese Entwicklung.
We should have in the future reasonable and affordable variety tests. So it is not, in our opinion, the main thing to go out of the system, but to adapt the systems to our desires and needs. Policymakers, value chains and consumer organizations jointly could help to finance eco-breeding and promote the ambitious growth we would like to see eco-breeding takes in the next future.
We need the relevant legislative framework to be adapted to the rules we want and allow for the breeding and testing under local and organic conditions.
It's really important that when consumers go to buy organic vegetable or organic fruits, they are sure that the seed, those vegetables and the fruits come from organic seeds.
We need region-specific varieties, many different ones, instead of mass products for large scale. And we need a breeding of a much larger number of crop species, not only the main crops we have.
We have a high diversity of food, so this also needs a diversity of seeds and varieties. And so we need other framework, other legal framework.
And this means that we must have, right from the beginning, another image, inner image, or another image of the plant we envisage to see on our fields. And this is not fulfilled by any conventional breeding.
From my point of view, a cultural question: how we will do this, how we will cultivate the land, and how our earth will look like in the future.